Welcome to my channel Education for You. So in our today's class, we will learn a very important issue of the Indian economy. And because of this issue or because of this problem, we the Indians are facing lots of problems in our country. So without wasting a moment, let's start what that problem is. So the problem that we will discuss today is poverty. Okay, so poverty, what is poverty? Poverty is a situation in which a person is not able to satisfy the basic needs of his life. Okay, it is a situation where a person is not able to fulfill the basic needs of his life. So what are the basic needs of a person? See, the basic needs of a person is what? Food. Then first one is food, second one is shelter, and third one is clothing. So food, clothing and shelter, these three are the basic necessities of a person's or human being's life. So without having these three things, we cannot live a life. So we cannot live as a human being. We have to live like animals. Okay, so if a person is not able to satisfy these three things in his life, it's food, then clothing and shelter, then that person is considered as a poor person, or the situation in which he is living is called a situation of poverty. Clear? Okay. So this situation of poverty, it can be classified into two types. Okay, first one is rural poverty and second one is urban poverty. Rural poverty means it prevails in rural areas. Okay, and urban poverty in urban areas. So we can take examples of different peoples who are living under this, who are poor or who are living under these two categories. Okay, so we can say the example of landless farmers. Okay, second one is we can say example of beggars. We can say example of child laborers. Then laborers who are working in factories, daily wage workers who are working in factories. Then street vendors. Then we can say different kinds of people who used to clean, who used to work as a maid in different means part-time maid or full-time maid in another people's house. So all these kind of people are considered as poor people, and they are living under the situation of poverty. So in this way we can learn what poverty is. Okay, so we have learned what poverty is, but only learning the definition is not enough. We have to know the what are the causes or reasons of poverty. Okay, so one by one we'll discuss the reasons also. First reason we can say is population growth, high level of population. So the countries like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, China, Bhutan, all these are what? Developing economies. Their economy is developing. They are not developed one like the foreign countries. So in these developing economies, the population rate is very high. So India is the second largest populated country in the world. Okay, so in such a high rate of population, it is very much it becomes a very severe problem for the country to satisfy the needs of each and every people. So because of this high population growth rate, there is poverty. The poverty prevails in a country like India. Then second thing is illiteracy. So people are not concerned to send their children to schools, and because of which they cannot learn, and these illiterate people cannot become a human resource in future, and they remain as a poor person in their whole life. So this is the second reason. Then third reason is low level of productivity because of using traditional methods, old traditional methods. In production, in agriculture sector, people are not using the modern methods, because of which our productivity cannot increase, and we cannot have the required level of productivity for our country, which is necessary. And because of which, we can another problem arises, that is the prices of the food grains increases, or the prices of the commodities increases. Okay, all these are some factors of or reasons of poverty. Then again, we can say corruption. Corruption is a very major problem. So in a country where the political system is corrupted, that country cannot improve at all. So first, we need to clean our political system, then only our economic system will be improved. Okay, then lack of proper infrastructure. So a corrupted political system cannot make a proper infrastructure in a country. So lack of proper infrastructure also, our country is underdeveloped, not having proper medical facilities, not having proper sanitation facilities, not having proper drinking water, not having the facilities for the students. So all these kinds of problems create a major or serious problems of poverty in our country. Okay, so here we will end our today's class, and in our next class we will try to learn some again more new things or concepts or issues about our country, about the Indian economy, and about the world economy also we will try to cover. So till today, thank you, and please like my video and share. If you like my explanation, please comment below in the comment box and share it with your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel Education for You. Thank you.